like our own, is being offered the opportunity to have any other powers that any other male combined authority in the country may have. Well, if you've read our devolution deal, we've pretty much got virtually everything that every other male combined authority has got, with the exception of the health powers that Great Manchester have got. Now, whether we would ever choose to use those powers is a different matter, but I do think we would want access to similar powers. The reason I raise this is I think we need to be much more ambitious as a city and a city region on this issue, because the levelling up, actually, I don't think should be limited solely to male combined authorities, because if there are powers that London has, for example, because that has a different devolution deal, Wales, Scotland, the north of Ireland, or indeed sort of credible comparisons from other parts of the world, I think we should be throwing those into our ask of the central government, quite frankly. I know specifically we will be doing similar work in terms of powers around transport on that, but have we thought specifically in terms of the employment skills agenda? Are there powers, for example, that other parts of the devolved United Kingdom have that we think could well be relevant and we would want to have for the Liverpool City region? Because the final point I sort of make is that we think about where devolution across the UK has come from, it's very much where there's a specific requirement in certain parts of the UK to be able to take a more kind of localised and determined focus for that area. That's where Scottish devolution came from, Welsh devolution, the situation in the north of Ireland, particularly London as well. Well, I actually think there is a very acute circumstance, both in terms of our economic and social situation in the city region, but also politically. I would have to look into the sort of election results here, but my guess is that there hasn't been a plurality of the vote. Right-wing government across this city region since the 1970s, if not before. So is there not the sort of more unique circumstances that drove the kind of devolution debate much further, in particular Scotland, Wales, or other parts of the United Kingdom? So I'll just sort of reiterate that point. I think we need to be on the front foot in terms of an ambitious ask. And are we looking at that, particularly in the employment skills?
It's a point very well made, Evans, and yes, there are some detailed conversations taking place with officials on that.
Just a note on the apprentices. Does this fund fall on from the skills strategy, the one 2018 to 2020? Is that going to, because that's coming to an end now, isn't it, the skills strategy? Well, we've got a target of 20,000 apprentices or something, I think I read.
Yes, that's the apprentice growth plan of 2018 to 2020, which we're in the process of reviewing for implementation of. There's no detail from government as to exactly what they want to do on apprenticeships. They're talking about valuing apprenticeships widely, but in terms of exactly what they want to do, and clearly I know Councillor Murray's raising issues about the operation of the apprenticeship levy. I know that's an issue that the committee, staff committee members have shared and expressed their concerns about in the past. We'll only know when we start to get into detailed conversations with government as to what their view might be. But clearly, they still want to support apprenticeships. That's welcome in terms of precise operation of it. It's too early to speculate on that, I'm afraid.
Is there any way that we can see where the amount of apprentices that we've already met that target, how many have we got actually in Liverpool, not just in the council? How many apprentices? Is it some data we can get somewhere online for that?
Yes, absolutely. We can get a note out on that. So we can certainly do something on apprenticeship starts. We can do it by age, and we can do it by level and rough area, framework of standards. So the curriculum area that they're studying in. So we can provide that information by email separately if that's acceptable.
Myself and Rob had a conversation outside the meeting this morning where that very point was raised about how we can get slice and dice
terms of scale, they're talking about £500 million of the UK Shared Prosperity Fund being used specifically to work and to help disadvantaged people. Darren has much more experience of European funding programmes than I do, but if they're talking about that over a six-year period, which would be commensurate with previous European programmes, then that's what, about £70 million a year, that's £65 million a year. That's not an awful lot of money, bearing in mind that our European Social Fund programme for the City Region for this six-year period was over £100 million. I think I can say that. In terms of what scale of the overall UK shared prosperity fund would be, that's still to be determined.
I appreciate the diplomacy, but you said £65 million a year is not a great deal for me.
Just one, in terms of the apprenticeship, can I have it broken down by ward? So I know how many apprenticeships were in the Old Town ward.
We're restricted by what's available in the domain, but we'll break it down as far as we can geographically.
Okay, thank you. Do we have any other questions? Go on, thank you.
Thank you very much. It's harmless, it's on the previous. That's what I'm looking for. Is there any chance that it's probably a redevelopment committee, but there's £1 million being spent in council board on the redevelopment of council roads, which tying in what we were discussing before about business as a green partner. Is there any chance of this committee at the next one when we get the update, and of course what they're doing, trying to invigorate the development of shops and businesses, so that we can tie in with what we're looking at?
It kind of sits at the intersection of regen and employment, because I think it does cross-cut across both directions. I'm going to ask that we do get an update on the extent to which that investment impacts on employment and skills in that area. So we can have that on the agenda. Now, I know that I just indicated that you'd like to respond to that, and then I'll give you a bit.
Unfortunately, that's it with me. I'm more than happy to bring the full presentation back and explain all the work that we've done, and kind of almost going back to, I think, Councillor Shortall's point earlier on about local high streets and things. My view is we need to do more around local high streets, and this is part of the testing ground, and we're really, really grateful to the Mind Authority for the money that's come forward around this project. So I'm more than happy to bring something forward and get them.
I'd in terms of pensions, could have in terms of quality and disability, and on the pensions, we had a disability for quality issues on the service.
Again, we're restricted by what available information is available publicly. We'll bring everything that we've got to you. There's certainly some national data available on the number of people with a disability around the pressure, and we can provide that information to the committee as well.
I was going to ask exactly the same, which will break down the policies across the board.